That's actually really frustrating. I should have gone with something with gravity. You know. Might have been easier. Though, look at that. Skills, man. I did not spill that bucket at all. You should go be over there. This corridor is starting to look really nice. No, this is where the crisps went. So those must have been separate crisps. Or maybe those were also separate crisps. And there's still a, you know, rogue pack of crisps somewhere. Rogue crisps. Oh god, what the fuck just bounced me up into the air? Why the fuck was my mob suddenly so bloody? Ah, there we go. Oh yeah. Catch that. Fix the rotation. Yeah, there we go. Doing it like real janitorial masters now. Also known as master janitors. Holy shit. Is it because I walk out of the pipes or something? And it just ended up me there? Woo! Must be. Holy shit, game, stop that. There's a thingy here. Cedric Mang. I have no idea what to use it in. I think the station that uses these things is upstairs. I didn't want to cover myself in blood though. But that is the only way upstairs for me right now. I leave it to the relative safety up here. I could get boxes from upstairs, which would mean I could get, like, gather up loose bits of people. And, oh god, I didn't realize my mob was this bloody. Had I done that, I would not have to run back again. perfect. No spillage there. Starting to get good at this stuff. Sense the, of course, hitting blood me there and getting good shit everywhere. This is probably not Barney. Because Barney already was flushed out the airlock. This is... I think this is Bob. That or Thomas? I don't know, they all look the same to me. Not to be racist or anything, but, you know. Default looking NPCs all look like default looking NPCs to me. Especially once they're already default looking NPC pieces. Alright, and we move in carefully. Ooh, and we spill the bloody water. And luckily for us, it was only relatively bloody water and it doesn't need to be cleaned up. Now, this is less lucky because this is. I think that's a tapeworm. Oh god, why did I do that? Question is, why did they take out the new bucket already? No, 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 you're getting back in there, Mr. Tapeworm. If these things are going rogue again? What are you doing up there? Okay, open the door again, because I have no idea where this guy came from. You're going in there as well. Close. And lose that pressure. I just like watching this, because look at them. Look at how they're just rushing for freedom. So, we even saw those rogue packs of crisps. Just go ahead and... reach for freedom. It is fantastic. Even my gloves are bloody now. Must have been punching people. Hand motions. I have no idea what I was trying to mean with them. Or with the sounds accompanying those motions. Can I hit this blood? Ah, my footsteps. My footprint 7. Oh, hello. These are problematic because I don't have a box to put them in. I need to fight. I need to clear myself above the top floor from which I can gather boxes. Yeah. So you can start putting these tapeworms into boxes. These are not probably intentions, not tapeworms. Because if they were tapeworms, this would be a really unhealthy work environment. To be fair, I'm probably wearing like some sort of a thing that, you know, denies them access to my sphincter. Or, you know, that is usually not from a tapeworm invasion begins, but still, you can never be too careful. God, you stink to these kids. No! Fuck it! Oh, you traitor! You know, I could put bits of people into buckets instead. That would work. I bet the poop box has moved a little again. I have no idea. Maybe there's like sort of a certain beat. Is it a boom in the box that makes the boom box move? Get in there, you fucking pack of crisps. Before you go rogue. Like this one, I thought it was a light. Spike of crisps. A rebellious pack of crisps. Alright, get over there. Well. This isn't looking too bad. Oh, am I kidding? This is a bloody mess. Literature. Literally. Not literature. Where did that even come from? Probably because it has the same root. Yeah. Alright. I'm allowed to spill this bucket. I did not though, so it's okay. I was gonna hope to pick it up and to become my Flutterface. How do I get these little strips moving? Because they don't want to move on their own. They're, if they didn't know better, I would think they're about. Can I punch them? No. Ah. No, no, look at these footsteps. I've done a mess. I've done a big mess. But luckily, now I will have a thing to put the shit in. I can also use a function to rotate it properly. Yes. Look at all that blood. Luckily for us, we got a nice clean bucket. And it's got water in it. I'm gonna use that water for good. Not evil. Alright, I'm gonna place this bucket here for safekeeping. Yes. Because there will be functions this bucket will be able to serve. Once the battle between good and evil has run its course. That or as a part of the battle. Good and evil. Yeah, okay, well, gravity would be really helpful with the whole try to stick things in things situation. Yeah. Well, luckily for me, most of the time, what I want is not that big a deal. I must have gathered some blood up with my people. Oh, you are coming with me before you cause a massive mess. Because you are someone's legs. And you know what can come out between someone's legs? Yeah, you guessed it. A massive mess. Bloody diarrhea. That's what can come out from between someone's legs. That and explosive bloody diarrhea. Probably. I would assume that things can just, you know, go worse and worse and worse as things go on. Alright. Can I just punt all of this blood around, like, to clear out the path? Me. I still won't be able to get that shit blood there. Okay, I'm gonna try to see if I can... Well... In principle, the plan wasn't too flawed. It's just that there's no gravity and these pants have gone loose. And of course the massive mess now. Look at that, thick bloody diarrhea everywhere. Everywhere. Oop, bucket. No, you will stay in your prison. You bucket will also go to prison. See if you can hit those legs. Then I will take this new bucket. A brand new bucket. A whole new bucket. And a fantastic fucking stay in your bloody airlock. New view. Yes. There we go. No spillage here. For this is not the spillage village. Also not the village village. Which is not the best thing to name your village. Because honestly, that doesn't just attract raiders. Yes. Alright, let's see, where can we continue? There's those really weird bloody things everywhere. Maybe I should bring a water bucket here. And hope I don't spill everything on the ground. Drive by. Alright. Prove to me that you are not pure evil, bucket. Prove it to me. Alright, they managed to... Whoa! That's not what I had in mind. That's also not what I had in mind. Once again! Sounded principle, but, you know, it just didn't work out. Why is there any bloodstain here? Why is there any bloodstain there? Depressurize that bitch! Also, my light from there is now gone. Gone! Gone forever. Okay. It looks stable. That's good. Like, this doesn't look like it's cleanable, so... Neither is that. Great. Get the pressure in there. I guess it's maybe becomes cleanable once the doors are open. Yeah, there we go. Maybe. Those bloodstains might be on the other side of the door, according to the game itself. Maybe. Yeah, this is too bloody already. Okay. Use the bucket! No! Don't spill the bucket. Bucket, come back! Bucket! You can go there. Like forever. New bucket, please. Thanks, bucket. And off to there, lucky go. Though we haven't cleaned him up for a while. I still don't actually know what I can do about that. No. I know what I can do about that. I can clean my mop. That's a severed leg! Do you want the severed leg? No, neither do I. Oh. Like, crawl up the wall or something. Just never come back into the thing. We don't need you here. You know, cleaning up a space station takes time. Just as gathering up 200 subscribers did. Once again, thank you. Thanks a lot. Now I have to clean up this bloody mess. It's your fault. Not at all my fault for choosing this as whatever I do when I reach a goal. Ah, no. There's still water in here. Hmm. I did it. I did it, ma. I cleaned him up without spilling shit everywhere. Okay. No. I'm moving too fast. Grab the corpse. Whoop. Carefully now. I said carefully now! Alright, we moved carefully then, I think. And that is moving in a way that should keep him from getting into my shit. What's up with you, Boombox? What's your deal? Ropes. Where did these bloody footsteps come from? Footprints, even. Once again, I just spill the water without gaining the benefits of the thing. Then we get like a meaty bit. Right. Nope, you stay still. I jump up. I do a focused strike with my mop. There's blood everywhere. This is worse than that one time with Shia LaBeouf. Like when he was an actual cannibal. Yeah. Like a boss. There's still like those little bits and pieces of people in here. If I go against those, I probably manage to make them spill blood everywhere. Can I use this to ram the blood me there? I can. Great. That's one blood stain out of there. You know, if I had left those for last, I probably would have had to use a bucket. Which reminds me, I do need to use a bucket. Oop. Not that I had in mind. Give me a bucket. That's a severed arm. I keep trying to grab the thing itself, not the bucket button, but okay. Maybe this is a quick dispenser service in that way. Does look like it's moving, so that's good. Ah, now. I see another part of him dancing over there. And there's flying blood around. The worst thing is delivering these by one because there's no gravity, so I can't put them in a container. Oh, yeah, no. Even the janitor box probably won't stay closed. Oh, we're making progress on an achievement. Oh well. Apparently there's a bloody hell abound. No! I spilled the bucket again. I wonder if there's an achievement for spilling all these buckets. Maybe there's an achievement for letting a full bucket of water out the airlock, though it won't stay that way because of the suction thing. Depressurization state of things, I mean. Hey, you! Intensive! You're probably the sphincter. You are not the sphincter. Sphincter is completely different from you. You are not the sphincter. I just had to make jokes about the sphincter. Get back here, bucket! This rebellion of the buckets. I can tolerate it no further, especially since they're not actually giving me buckets, they're giving me body parts. Like, was there even enough stuff on this ship to justify all these pieces of leg? Fuck you, bucket. You're a mean one. And like, the next item already is a body part. That machine is blocked up real bad. But there's no alternative to use either. And my bob actually isn't all that bloody, what am I doing? It's all because of the intention I was delivering, wasn't it? Now it's certainly bloody enough. Something to keep in mind is the fact that when you jump up and you look downwards, you may end up landing on the bucket. Instead, you punch the bucket with your mop. Though that doesn't count as a punch anymore because you're not using your fist. And everyone knows punching is all about the way of the fist. That or punching people. Which may or may not include the way of the fist. But yeah, punching is generally about punching people. That makes perfect sense. Alright, let's just, you know, make our way up by this wall. Maybe there's no body bits. Yeah, there's a body bit. Alright, body bit, I need you to stay midair here. Okay, I actually do need to deliver you because otherwise you'll cause me trouble. Like, I think there's another airlock outside, probably. Like, upstairs, I mean. Not outside. But I hope I don't have to clean up the outside. I'm not sure I'm equipped for that. But the airlock does, in fact, include the possibility to open it from the inside. So, there is quite certainly a possibility that I may have to clean up that bit as well. Just couldn't hold on to the ball or the box. Like, it just rebelled. Like, this is the rebellion of inanimate items. This is how the world ends. Not with a bang, but with a boing 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 against various objects. Ooh, hello. That's another body bit. And it got blood on things. I don't like that. I don't appreciate that at all. Get out of there. Yeah. Close the door. Clean that shit out. No, that shit doesn't even matter enough to me anymore. I'm not even gonna watch it get sucked out to the space. Oh god, why did I do that? I could have watched that stuff get sucked out into space. And there isn't a lot of blood here. Now, this is where we started out, right? Yes. No, that's no airlock. That's my footprint. Those are also my footprints. There is no airlocks here. And those boxes aren't completely useless here because there's just no way. I want to summon the elevator. How do I summon the elevator? All in all though, I will need to actually deliver this to the thing as well, so understand. I can just throw them all into the pit like that. None of these are body bits. That must be the light that I accidentally broke. That wasn't enough momentum. I was hoping for more. Rawr, like that. Yeah. Like you jump in the air, and you go rawr. Like it's the tiniest sprint. Rawr. I need to come up here with like a million buckets of water and no limbs. Well, my own limbs, but no extra limbs, you know. Won't accept from those from the dispenser. Yes. Alright. Right. So I now have access to that thing. Probably. Oh, haven't I begun my shift yet? That's a but. That's probably for ending the shift. Probably. Yeah. We're not gonna do that until we are quite certain we have cleaned the place up. This interior of it. How did you do that? Silly bit of paper. That's an intense in, and you're coming with me. Oh, there's another body pit. Small problem. I had a closed airlock. Why was there still a bucket in there? Ah, the buckets, they rebel against the rifle master. That is me. The rebellion of the buckets shall not be forgotten. In fact, I'm gonna. Yo, Intensin, you go back inside. Bad Intensin. But their rebellion is not as sacrilegious to me as. You know. The rebellion of the buckets! Get in back in their box. You get it. You just get in there, but you're not a bucket, you're a thing, barrel. Yes, a barrel thing. Alright, what else do we have here? Another barrel thing. That can go inside, enjoy the company of all those boxes and the rogue bucket. Like the 100% rogue bucket. No multi-classing or anything. None of it. Not a single little piece of multiclassing for that bucket. For it is a rogue bucket. As said, when I said it was a rogue bucket. I don't know if that sort of talk would be because of a low wisdom modifier or a low charisma modifier when it came to D&D. I haven't played D&D yet. I've been playing a little bit of Pathfinder now. It has gone very oddly. Because my party members are weird. Yes. And in all fairness, our entire party is built around concepts that don't really work all that well. I intend to post some out of context quotes from that on my channel at some point. Once things. Once our Tiefling Cleric finishes the banner thing. Yeah. Me! Ah, yes. Now, you are a roguelite. Because you're not turn-based. Go away. Right, there's also that one piece of intensity somewhere still, and oh god. I need to clean my mop. Whee! I'm kind of over proud about the roguelite joke. Yeah. You are not a bucket, you are an arm. Like, you don't... There's no way I can use it to clean them up. Technically the brawler could be, but it would take so much time. Like, first I'd have to make sure that the arm was completely drained of all blood or anything else that could, you know, spill. Or I could just skin it and, like, make a skin rag. Which doesn't sound terribly effective. No offense. Is this rust? Is that like permanent damage? Is that something I cannot clean up? Because that's something I've come to accept in the military. There are some things you just can't clean up. They're just... You'd need to go full paint bucket on them. And as you know, buckets are mean things, so... You can't always just full bucket someone. Rah! Oh, this crunched up piece of paper here. Rah! Yes, okay, the zero gravity controls are, as many people would expect, kinda odd to control. Because there's no gravity to them. And this box is important. This box is important. This box is like... Oh yeah, of course I'm gonna collect every gun in the level. Yeah. Okay, let's get on the ground. And if you find any guns, we're gonna put it in the box. Hoping, of course, the guns just don't fly out of the box. Because while we encourage thinking outside the box, we don't encourage actually leaving the box. Especially since guns are not supposed to think in the first place. You know, that's usually for other sort of weapons, like broadswords. What is that? Probably irrelevant. Can I get this? Whoa. Yeah, I can get this leg. I'm gonna take pretty many trips for that today. Quite a few. No, I didn't mean to straighten you up, leg. Yeah, no! In all fairness, that spillage was okay. Okay, you roguelite. You're getting published. Right then, you get out of here! That was weird. Hello! I'm not as injured the mad. I know the first is Harbinger, Spiff Angler 24, Boxes Made and Kid Aspect, this is 13, and all right, little guy, and you're returning to my magical adventure in this thing. That is the Visceral Cleanup Detail, and we are like on a place with no gravity, like no real gravity, so it's proving itself to be quite challenging to clean up, but you know, that's why we're here. They needed the best, and they got me instead.